This girl's.
My name is Tony Thomas, and you're watching Hardwired Exotics on YouTube.
What's going on, YouTube? So today, we're going to talk about hypos, but first, I got to show you something.
Nail time.
So, we got all kind of goodies here from, obviously, Lucy Land ball pythons. So, if you don't know Kayla, then go check her out. T-shirts. Not slacking on the back, as Billy says. This is a young girl who has an outstanding collection, outstanding knowledge, and actually done a live interview on or with her a few weeks ago, and she drilled me with questions, guys. I'm telling you, she is she's something else. So anyway, really big thank you for sending this stuff out. We weren't expecting it. And she wrote us a note too. Says, thank you for all the support and giving me an awesome opportunity. Sure hope you enjoy the stickers and shirts. And of course we will. And for everybody else that don't know, go check her out. Boom, check this thing out. Is this not beautiful? Absolutely stunning piece here. So a friend of ours, Millie Manning, she's the one that done the painting that was hanging in that room. Until we had to move it to set a rack there. Now we've taken the rack out and haven't put the painting back up because we're fixing to move anyway, so no point in hanging again. But anyway, she sent us this in the mail along with some crazy t-shirts. Not going to show you t-shirts yet. There's going to be something special probably about to happen with that. But anyway, thank you, Millie, for this beautiful drawing. This is actually a digital drawing that she printed out for us. So it's something she's starting to do. If you want some more information on how you could get this drawing or something like it or something custom, let me know. I'll send you tours. Fantastic artist. So, all right, now back to the hypos. We actually have just had three or four clutches at this point. But the first two clutches of hypos, y'all seen us cut them or some of them come out, I don't know. But anyway, all of them have shed out and most of these have started eating. So I'm not going to try to keep the separation in both clutches because they're very similar genes, but I'm just going to show you a bunch of hypos, a bunch of stuff's on Morph Market, a bunch of it fixing to get there pretty soon. So let's start out with just a beautiful basic hypo. So this is probably the nicest hypo that I have personally ever hatched and probably ever seen. This girl is just glowing. So hypo is a recessive genetic trait. So you need either visual or heads on both sides in order to make more of them. And hypo lost some steam there for a while, but it is definitely coming back and coming back strong. So beautiful girl, she is available. And this is the base mutation. So nothing else here but single gene hypo. So we've done a lot of chocolate stuff, and a lot of people have a hard time seeing chocolate in their hypo stuff. So this is chocolate hypo. And as you can tell, they're eating well. So the basic chocolate hypo is gonna be very similar if you don't have anything to compare to. So the fact that we have a single gene hypo and chocolate hypos in these clutches makes it easier to identify, but chocolate hypo can be very difficult to spot out if you don't have both of the combos there to look at. So Anyway, I think this is a male, and I think it might be the only chocolate hypo that's actually left available. So next up, one more single gene. This is a pastel hypo. A lot of people don't know it, but pastel works really good with hypo. This girl is pretty much just a regular example of what you're looking for in a pastel hypo. More yellow tint, and the head here is going to be really white or blushed out. So just a basic pastel hypo. Looks really great. This ages well. It's just a fantastic combo to have in your collection. So one of the staples in the ball python world is Mojave. And this guy has pastel and Mojave. So you can really tell the difference when they're right here beside each other. Both have the white out head, that's the pastel. But the Mojave is gonna be the pattern in this animal. So if this didn't have pastel, the same pattern would be there. It would just be a little bit darker overall. So really interesting combo. That's what the mom to this particular one was, is pastel Mojave hypo. It's just a gorgeous animal, even as an adult. So don't skip over your pastel hypo stuff. So this is actually mom here. This is pastel Mojave hypo. Just a beautiful snake. It's crazy how much it changes. But this girl is big. You know, 9-10 egg layer, and absolutely stunning, even as an adult. So unfortunately, I didn't hatch out a GHI hypo, which is another part or piece of this puzzle. So we're gonna have to skip straight to the chocolate hypo GHI. So you can see a lot of the characteristics from the chocolate hypo that play right over into the GHI version. But obviously GHI, you know, is in this animal. It screams GHI. So chocolate is the gene that is more difficult to pick out in this combo, but it's easy to see it when you have it compared to something. So made a bunch of these GHI chocolate hypos. I think we have two males available left. The girls sold really quick, and it is a fantastic combo. The dad to these is a chocolate GHI hypo, and you know, it's a fantastic animal. If I have it breeding, then there's a reason why. So one of the great things about doing this is the interaction that different genes give different combos. This GHI Mojave hypo, it's crazy that there's only one gene difference. So chocolate here, Mojave here, it's just a phenomenal looking animal, and looks great as an adult too. This is a girl. She is available. The final animal that I'm going to show you today is what I believe to be a GHI Mojave chocolate. It's very hard to really see the difference in GHI Mojave hypo versus the GHI Mojave hypo with the chocolate, but once you have them to compare to, you can see it a little bit easier. So chocolate's going to lighten this up a little bit. It's going to take away from the dorsal pattern some, and it's also going to make this stripe down the back a little bit more creamy. So that's why I believe that this is chocolate, and this is just the regular GHI Mojave. This is more typical looking from what you see in the GHI Mojave hypos, and this girl just stands out being different, so pretty sure it's the chocolate. So anyway, just wanted to get you up to date on the hypo stuff. If you want anything, hit me up. A lot of it's going on Morph Market, the website, and all that jazz, so.
I jumped.
It's not even facing you.
Tony, get there.
I done lost my train of thought. See you next week.
Thanks for watching Hardwired Exotics, and make sure you subscribe. Bye!